Togo, the official match ball of the AFCON 2021 has been launched by CAF. AFCON is just over a month away, and it's quite interesting how preparations are going for it ahead of the AFCON. But today I have some interesting news to discuss with you. There's a possibility that South Africa could be in AFCON 2021. We'll be looking at why that chance has come up now. We'll also be talking about comments passed by Liverpool manager Jurgen Klopp that has got everyone talking. He called the AFCON a little tournament in January, and a lot of people are annoyed by that. I'll be sharing my thoughts on it with you today. As usual, subscribe if you have not, click on the notification bell to get more updates. So that's, we talk about AFCON and the teams participating, which are 24. We also have to talk about the fact that Zimbabwe is the country that looks like it could be disqualified from the African Cup of Nations. Why? Well, there are some growing concerns as the government has interfered in footballing activities. That's the work of ZIFA, that's Zimbabwean Football Association. Zimbabwe's participation in next year's African Cup of Nations is in danger after the board of its football association was suspended by the country's government-appointed Sports and Recreation SRC with immediate effect. That was a couple of days ago. The Ministry of Sport is headed by former Olympian Christy Coventry, and it's accused of interfering in footballing activities. Now, Football World's governing body, FIFA, disapproves of government interference in running of member associations and has banned countries from all forms of football as a result of this in the past. And I'll take, if my memory serves me right, it happened to Sierra Leone back in the preparation for AFCON 2019. They were in Ghana's group, and Sierra Leone were banned, and hence Ghana did not even need to play their final game to know that they had qualified. They qualified because Sierra Leone was not in the reckoning for the competition qualifier. So if this is not something that is addressed quickly, it could be that Zimbabwe would be out of the AFCON and would create an opening for two countries. I'll be going to that closely. Now, this decision has been considered following several incidents of gross incompetence on the part of ZIFA, contrary to the national interest, said the SRC, which is the Sports and Recreation. Now, the reasons given for the ban include alleged sexual harassment of female referees by technical staff and allegations of fraud. The Felton Kabongo-led ZIFA board is yet to respond to the suspension, which comes 2 days after the men's national team ended their World Cup qualifying campaign. After a 1-1 draw with Ethiopia, Zimbabwe finished the bottom of the group. They had just earned 2 points. There is also a statutory mandated body to regulate and develop sports and recreation in Zimbabwe. Also detailed other reasons for the suspension, including alleged mismanagement and lack of accountability in the use of public funds. They said, "We are prepared in many respects for whatever might happen," he said. "If FIFA decides to ban Zimbabwe football, we are prepared for that. If it does happen, we look at it being a short-term measure. Zimbabwe football needs this opportunity just to fix itself. If we are out of international football for a year, 2 years, that's fine. If we are suspended from AFCON next year, we are prepared for that. That is fine. We need to deal with football." The SRC took similar action in 2019 with Zimbabwe cricket, setting up an interim leadership and receiving a 3-month suspension from the International Cricket Council. The ICC readmitted Zimbabwe cricket after the reinstatement of the board. The SRC board member Karen Mutasa is hoping for more positive outcome this time. We would hope that FIFA would want to see the evidence that's presented to them, and that they would work with us to build football in Zimbabwe, and even to assist with appointing an interim committee. So this is why Zimbabwe could be removed, based on a FIFA's regulation on government interference. This is why they could be removed from the competition, which is the African Cup of Nations, and it could create an opening for either one, South Africa and Zambia. South Africa, because South Africa were the third best team in the qualifiers. They finished with 10 points, but unfortunately were edged out by Sudan and Ghana in the qualifying stages of the competition. They have 10 points, the highest of any of the third best placed teams in the competition. Also, they can use the groups in which Zimbabwe is in, and Zambia is the third team in that group, so they could also be considered for the competition, which is the African Cup of Nations next year. It will be great news for South Africans, I'm sure, if that is what's going to be used to select a replacement for Zimbabwe, if they are actually suspended. But we'll see what happens in the coming days, whether FIFA will actually ban them or CAF will allow this to go and look at the evidence before looking at the next course of action. Zimbabwe are ready to face the consequences. We'll see what happens in the coming days. My next story has to do with Liverpool manager Jurgen Klopp, who has come under a lot of scrutiny after this morning. This video was posted on social media, courtesy Beanie Man Sports. And now, in a build-up to Champions League, which they have qualified for the knockout stages already, Liverpool manager Jurgen Klopp was saying this at the press conference about the African Cup of Nations. Let's have a listen to what he said.
The manager heard it so often, but in January, it's this little tournament in Africa.
So you heard Jurgen Klopp there saying that a little competition called the African Cup of Nations. And many people are not happy by Jurgen Klopp describing the African Cup of Nations, Africa's biggest continental event, as a little competition. Others are saying it is sarcasm. We shouldn't take it too personally. But the truth is that the African Cup of Nations is no small competition. Whether sarcasm or not, Mr. Jurgen Klopp probably shouldn't have said that, and a lot of people are peeved by this. I think that the African Cup of Nations, at the time it is played, according to him, serves as an inconvenience, because his main team, or his potent team, is comprised of players from that part of the continent who help him and the team get a lot of results, and he sees it as an inconvenience that is going to disrupt his season and Liverpool's momentum in the English Premier League. That being said, you cannot be calling the African Cup of Nations a little competition. I get his frustrations. I get that the African Cup of Nations happening in January will not be convenient for a club football, but then again, he could have addressed the matter better. But hey, he is human. He makes a lot of mistakes at times, and I think that yes, he should correct himself, because the AFCON is anything but a little competition. The AFCON deserves much more reverence. I was happy when the AFCON started being played, especially AFCON 2019 in June. When it happens like that, it helps all of us, because the world eyes will be on it much more. Now there'll be divided attention between club football and international football. Not saying that is why we should change it, but looking at things from that perspective, it will be in our best interest to have the AFCON removed from probably a club football, or taking place after club football. Hopefully we return to hosting the AFCON later on in June in the odd numbered years, when probably there will be no other football. But this has happened because club football outside Europe has dominated the world. It shouldn't be any big deal pausing and playing it, like how we are going to pause for the World Cup to be played. Probably the AFCON is not considered as much of a tournament that deserves a pause in club football for it to take place, and I get that. It does not involve the whole world as the World Cup does, but AFCON needs to get the spotlight it deserves. It's one of Africa's biggest tournaments, and I think that changing it back to odd numbered years and being played in that summer of odd numbered years would go a long way to help the competition and its publicity as loyal, as well as the attention it gets. Jurgen Klopp was not right to say that, and I'm sure he didn't mean any malice through those comments, but I think that AFCON deserves the respect, and that those comments do not help the competition in any way. He needs African players in his club that help his club thrive. And seeing it as an inconvenience, I'm sure that's why he said that. But let me know your thoughts in the comments box on this. Do you think Jurgen Klopp should apologize for what he said? Let me know your thoughts in the comments box. So that has been it for today. The official match ball for the African Cup of Nations has been launched. Also, we'll be talking about the possibility of South Africa going to AFCON, and then Jurgen Klopp's comments that has got everyone talking. I'll see you guys in the next one. Enjoy your day.